Let's look at how CockroachDB uses the Raft protocol to perform writes in a distributed and durable manner. This is required knowledge for anyone who wants to understand where CockroachDB's guarantees come from. If you're really interested in the details, follow the links below because this is one area where anyone curious can always learn more. Raft is an algorithm that allows a distributed set of servers to agree on any values without losing the record of that value, even in the face of node failure. CockroachDB uses it to perform all writes. Recall that CockroachDB organizes its data into a key space, divided into ranges, and distributes replicas of each range throughout the cluster based on the replication factor. For CockroachDB, each range defines a Raft group. The cluster has 7 ranges, so there will be 7 Raft groups. Let's look at one. Before we get into the details of Raft, though, CockroachDB has a concept of something called a lease, which it assigns to one of these replicas, called the leaseholder. Its job will be to serve reads on its own, bypassing Raft, but also keeping track of write commits so it knows not to show writes until they're durable. Let's put a lease on one of those replicas. Now all reads and writes to the range will be sent to that node. Now let's talk about Raft. The first thing to know about Raft is that replicas are either leaders or followers. Leaders coordinate the distributed write process while followers assist. If a follower doesn't see a heartbeat from a leader, it'll get a randomized timeout, declare itself a candidate, and call for an election. Majority vote makes it a leader. The process takes seconds. Let's elect a leader. I've made the leader the same as the leaseholder, and while they're different roles, in practice, CockroachDB does a good job of keeping the lease with the leader for efficiency, so we'll assume that scenario. Writes are kicked off by the leaseholder, which tells the leader to begin the process. Here's an insert. The leader first appends the command to its Raft log, which is an ordered set of commands, on disk. The leader then proposes the write to the followers. Each follower will replicate the command on its own Raft log. I showed only one replication so far, since that's enough for a majority. Even without hitting the third node, the write will persist through any single node failure. Consensus has been achieved, but the leader doesn't know that yet, so the follower has to let it know. At this point, the leader knows the Raft command was replicated, so it can commit the write and notify the leaseholder to begin showing it to readers. Eventually, that write will go to every replica. Let's look at our full cluster with a leader for each range to get a big picture sense of things. Here, each range has one replica that's its leader and its leaseholder. All SQL operations are routed to the appropriate leaseholders. Reads are returned while writes are passed to the leaders to start building consensus. So, what have we learned? We've seen that the leaseholder ensures that readers only see committed writes, and that replicas of a range together form a Raft group that elects one leader. We've seen how a distributed consensus is achieved for writes, and that's how Raft works in CockroachDB.